Welcome to this lightning talk about SARUS. My name is Lukas Benedicic. I am group lead for the Infrastructure and Development Services Group at CSCS. Today, with a special focus, a particular focus on the OCI standard features that this container engine for HPC has. So the SARUS container engine has been specifically designed with the requirements of HPC installations in mind. That means we are talking about clusters with multiple users, with specific hardware for targeted at high performance, like for example GPUs or high performance interconnects like InfiniBand. Another important feature that that SARUS has is the fact that it has a consistent user interface with Docker. That means that our users don't have to learn a new set of CLI options in order to operate with SARUS. This is in our case very important because we don't want users to learn a new or yet another container engine, but having the smallest learning curve as possible. Additionally, SARUS enables the use of standard open and upstream components in HPC systems. What this means is that SARUS brings the OCI stack to HPC systems, including compatible runtimes like RunC and CRun, and OCI hooks that enable transparent native performance. This architecture, we believe, enables vendor engagement, as we will see a little bit later. For those of you who are not aware, OCI stands for Open Container Initiative. It is an open governance structure for creating industry standards around container formats and runtime. Now specifically, OCI hooks are external programs that are executed at certain points in the lifetime of a container. Now these programs are meant to customize the behavior of a particular container. If we look at the diagram below, we can see that during the lifetime of a container, from its creation until the moment it is destroyed, we are able to attach these different external programs to certain points during its lifetime. For example, there is a pre-start, a post-start, and a post-stop points. For example, SARUS, before starting the container, it does a runtime replacement of the libraries that are critical for the performance of the container that is being deployed. Once that happens, SARUS goes out sending notifications if there are any of those, and before destroying the container itself, it does the necessary cleanup. Now, what does this mean in practice? We can configure hooks, the hooks that are available with the SARUS installation, to match specific features on a certain system. Containers leverage on the performance on the systems that they are being deployed on. Now, let me quickly explain this. Look, if we look at the diagram here, we see in the left-hand side, we see a laptop running a Docker container, right? Now, you can think about the laptop running a Docker container as the lab environment. So it's the place where I author my containers. Now, when I move from my laptop to a small cluster, for example, my lab cluster, I have a SARUS installation there that has the MPI hook already installed by the sysadmins. So the sysadmins, when they installed SARUS, they made sure that the MPI hook installed there uses the high performance MPI libraries, for example, InfiniBand enabled, so that when I bring my container, it can transparently access these InfiniBand devices. Now, at some point, especially during scientific workflows, the small cluster that we use in a lab environment or a university environment is not enough. So we move to a supercomputer, like for example, flagship system at CSCS, where not only we can leverage from using the Cray MPI stack, and additionally by accessing GPU devices through the GPU hook. The important part here is to identify the fact that the original container does not require a priori any changes whatsoever. It is a self-sufficient portable software stack that can be deployed on top of different systems, taking advantage of the performance features of each of them. This runtime customization of portable images that SARUS does makes it possible for the image to remain portable and self-sufficient, while the hooks cover the last mile at deployment time to create machine-specific high-performance containers. This creates a clear separation of concerns. On the one hand, container engines or runtime developers, for example, like RunC, CRun, SARUS, Podman, and so on, who do not need to integrate or even reverse engineer specifics of high performance technologies. On the other hand, vendors or technology experts, like for example NVIDIA or Cray, who can develop, and in the case of NVIDIA already developed, feature specific extensions, in this case hooks, without having to know how the containers are created. So NVIDIA specifically created an OCI hook for accessing GPU devices. And this is one of the hooks that SARUS leverages during deployment time in order for the container images to access GPU devices natively without losing any performance. Ideally, this results in higher quality support of specific technologies in containers. Now, let me talk a little bit about the OCI hooks we are currently using and we have been using at CSCS. So I mentioned earlier the NVIDIA Container Toolkit for GPU support. That is the OCI hook created by NVIDIA and open source by NVIDIA. We are taking that specific hook as is and use it under SARUS without any changes whatsoever, and it's been working very well. Another hook has been developed at CSCS is the MPI hook that currently supports mPitch based MPI stacks. It provides native performance from host MPI based libraries, and as mentioned, it has been developed at CSCS and it's already bundled with SARUS. Another hook that we've been using is the glibc hook. What the glibc hook does is to replace at deployment time the glibc set of libraries so that the host-based MPI can be used without changes. This particular hook has also been developed at CSCS and is also bundled together with SARUS. Yet another hook that we developed at CSCS is the SSH hook. We use this hook in order to enable SSH connections towards the container. This is very useful for containers that deploy network services or require network connections. So with this specific hook, you can tunnel any network connection from inside a container through an SSH server that is bundled inside this SSH hook. Another hook that we developed at CSCS is the synchronization hook that we use with Slurm. It does something that is very simple but also very important. It just waits for all the processes inside the Slurm job to start before actually launching the containerized applications. A wait fence, if you wish, that waits for all the containers to be deployed by Slurm before actually starting the containerized applications to avoid any kind of miscommunications between the processes. And the last one that I'm going to talk about today is the timestamp hook. This one is useful for developers and also for doing performance analysis, so you can see at which step your container is spending more time. The latest updates of the SARUS runtime itself. You know that SARUS has been in production on PeaceDyne, the CSCS flagship system, since November 2019. So if you have an account of PeaceDyne or you are about to run a project there, so you will be able to bring your Docker images and deploy them as they are without any changes there. Now release 1.1.0 features some security updates. We also added the propagation of CPU affinity, something that you can do at the slurm level, and it was not possible to propagate, or initially was not possible to propagate inside the container. Now this is possible. We also improved the number of features of OCIX hooks, from the way that they scan the libraries inside the container, the number of implementations that they are aware of. In release 1.2.0, this is the most recent one, we added a login mechanism from OCI hooks. So now OCI hooks can send messages to the user directly through the terminal, so that you can actually see as a user what is going on with the hooks as they are executed. We also improved the image pooling performance quite a bit. This is especially important for bigger container images that are pulled from remote registries. The building and compilation process of SARUS has been also greatly improved in 1.2.0, and a SPAC package has been created. So if you are interested in testing SARUS, you don't have to compile it yourself. You can just install it using SPAC and give it a quick and easy test drive. One or two words about the things that we are currently working on. We are looking at alternatives for the current privileged rootFS mounts. So we are looking at the way SquashFS performs at scale. This is something that we are currently learning. We have identified a number of performance bottlenecks there, but more work is needed in order to better understand where the time is going. We've been looking at fuse overlay FS, but unfortunately that requires a kernel that is newer than 4.18, and this is not always widely available, especially in HPC systems, which usually feature older kernels. We are also working as we speak on an open MPI libfabric hook. That means that will give you the ability not only to deploy MPitch based MPI applications as we support today, but also open MPI applications through the libfabric interface. There are also some additional features that we are currently working on specifically for the OCI hooks. Now, we do have a work in progress about the hook configuration and selection by the engine. Since there is currently in this specific area a lack of standards in the OCI specifications, we are currently following the model used by Potman. We are also adding different CLI options at the container engine level, so that users will be able to enable or disable specific hooks, and also passing arguments to them. That means, for example, specifying mount points with environment variables, or for example, selecting the flavor of MPI that your application uses. If you're interested in testing SARUS, please check it on GitHub. It's available, of course, open source, BSD licensed, full documentation available at Read the Docs, that it's updated regularly. You have a quick start install on that link there. For any additional details and a more in-depth analysis, you can refer to the paper here, which contains all the details regarding the architecture, explanation, the rationale behind the design, and also a number of performance tests and analysis that that many of you will find useful. With that, I would like to close this lightning talk, thanking you very much for your attention, and I hope you will give SARUS a test drive and just let us know should you need any help doing that. Thanks again.